start of another scenic highway. Nebo Loop Scenic Byway. Let's see where we go. Water comes in there. Fills up the lake here. And drains out here. Nice little waterfall. Wish I heard that. I'm here. Gonna drive up here. Saw Creek Overlook. Devil's Kitchen Geological Site.
Pretty neat.
7,000 feet. Snow on the mountain over there. Look at the view up here. It's beautiful. Right there's the road I just came up on. It makes a loop. Oh, look at that. I am at the Salt Flat Overlook. Beautiful area. I am at Devil's Kitchen. It's also referred to as a mini Bryce Canyon. Red rock. Probably saw some of that as I was driving up. Say it's not really a hike, it's more of a stroll. So let's see. They got a paved path. Nice, and there's a picnic table up there. Let's stroll out and see Mini Bryce Canyon. Oh, here we go, Mini Bryce Canyon. And it is a good Mini Bryce Canyon. It's got the hoodoos and everything. Red rock, look at that. So nice. Almost looks like a lion's head or something. Something out of the Wizard of Oz. Stroll down here on a paved path. Can't beat that. This is Bear Canyon. Mount Nebo. Tallest one right there. Look at that mountain with snow. This is Mount Nebo. It's the highest mountain in the Wasatch Mountain Range. It rises 11,928 feet. Right over here, if you're quiet, now you don't have to be quiet, but I mean, if you listen, if this camera will pick it up. Snow is melting and dripping down, and down there I can't see it, but I can hear it. There's a waterfall somewhere. Just beautiful. forth. There she is, tallest one. Nebo Loop, the scenic byway, is 38 miles long. I've driven about 12 of it. So it was warm, but it was warm down in the lower elevation. When I got up here, I started noticing a cool breeze because I'm at about 8,000 feet elevation. So I decided to pull over and just park here for the night. Got a great view. Found a geocache nearby. Fire ring, so you know it's an approved campsite, and of course it's free. But then look, as I get close to the edge, it goes down there, way down. It's a steep drop off. Good thing the DanVan didn't roll backwards. Oh, it's beautiful. I'll get a good night's sleep and then I'll head off in the morning and continue this beautiful drive on Nebo Loop. This is another mountain overlook. I think it's the Sanguin overlook. And there it is, the mountain. Pretty neat. This is what is known as Bald Mountain Overlook. I guess that's Bald Mountain, although it doesn't look too bald, but it is. Alrighty. Still beautiful country. This is the Utah Lake Overlook, and that's it way out there. Way out there. Little morning haze is preventing it from coming in focus, but that's Utah Lake. Betty came over to see Rose. It was the day before Rose's birthday. And Betty, being a good friend, said, "Rose, tomorrow's your birthday. What do you want for your birthday?" And Rose thought, and she says, "I'd like to be 10 again." Betty thought for a minute. She said, "All right, I'll tell you what." She says, "Tomorrow morning, I'll come over, pick you up, take you to breakfast, and we'll spend the day together." Rose didn't see anything wrong with that, but she said, "Okay." So Betty, sure enough, picked her up. And they went to IHOP, and they had chocolate chip pancakes with bananas and syrup and whipped cream and everything. And then Betty took Rose to a park where there was a Ferris wheel and a merry-go-round, and they rode that. And they ate popcorn and walked in the park. And then they went out to dinner, and they went to dinner was at Chuck E. Cheese's, and they had pizza. And then Betty took Rose home and she said, "Well, Rose, how did it feel to be 10 again?" And Rose looked at her and said, "When I said I wanted to be 10 again, I meant dress size."